So hi everyone, this is Sagar Shah and today I'm sitting with one of India's brightest talents, 10-year-old Om Kadam.
Yes.
You're 10-year-old?
Yes.
Wow, amazing. So Om, you are the current Asian champion under-10.
Yes.
And what are your other achievements?
National champion, I am under-9.
You're under-9 national champion, okay. So here is a boy who is clearly one of the best players in his age category in India. And today, Om, you're going to show us one of your favorite games.
Yes.
From which tournament?
Asian Youth.
Asian Youth, which was held in Thailand just a few days ago.
Yes.
Okay, so how did that game go? Can you show us your white?
Yes. E4.
Okay.
C5. Knight F3. Knight C6. D4. Cd4. Knight D4. Knight F6.
So Om, right now you don't have a score sheet with you.
Yes.
And you're just saying the game. So you can remember all of your games?
Yes.
How? You have all the games in your mind?
Yes.
Amazing. So you don't need a score sheet after the game, you just put your games into the computer. Okay. And what sort of a player you are?
Attacking, just tactical and rash.
You are rash, attacking and tactical. So you like to attack a lot?
Yes.
Okay. So show us the game forward. You played knight c3 here?
Knight c3, yes. E5. Knight db5. D6.
Do you know what this opening is called? Sveshnikov, yes?
Yes.
So, over here, do you think that this d5 square is a weakness?
Yes.
Okay.
Really.
So how did you take advantage of that?
I played bishop g5.
Okay.
A6. Knight a3. b5. Knight d5.
Did you know the theory?
Yes.
Till what point you tell us? Till what point do you know?
Bishop e7, bishop f6, bishop f6, c3, short castles, h4.
h4?
Yes.
This is still theory?
Yes.
What is the idea of this one?
h4, it's like stopping bishop g5. And then the knight comes c2 e3 and the d5 knight is supported.
And this is a strong knight on d5. Okay.
He cannot take on h4 because of queen h5.
Right. So you played h4 over here and you had prepared this.
Yes.
How do you prepare your openings?
On ChessBase with taking games of players.
Okay, so you use this reference function
you
find games,
yes.
And you have a very good memory, so you remember them.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Bishop e7.
Bishop to e7.
The main line is bishop e6.
Okay.
Knight c2. Yes, rook b8 and knight e3 and white is really better.
Yeah.
Some bishop e7 and f5 comes, but after g3 and bishop g2, the c6 knight is hanging in the diagonal.
Okay.
So tactics some comes.
So something like this
F5
happens,
then,
yeah?
Yes.
And then you could...
E takes, bishop takes and bishop g2. And this is a very strong position for white.
Okay. So you are... you think that this position is already good for white?
Yes.
But in the game, instead of... instead of playing bishop to e6, he went bishop e7.
Yes.
Okay. And then what did you play?
g3. Mm-hmm. Bishop e6. Knight c2. Rook b8. Knight c3. Queen d7.
So you are not afraid that your king is still in the center?
No, because after f5, e5, bishop f5 and bishop g2, there is nothing black can do.
Okay.
To attack my king. So, rook fc8.
No, queen d7, you played bishop
g2. Rook fc8.
Did you consider that this move over here, like, your bishop is not so great and his bishop is a good bishop.
Yes, but I think after bishop h3, queen d7, bishop e6, and after fe6 there is nothing on d5 white can do, and black is only coming d5.
Okay.
And the f2 point is weak.
So that is the reason why you went for bishop to g2 here.
Yes.
After knight c3.
Rook fc8, short castles. A5.
And in this position, what is white's main aim? Like, what? How should white play according to you?
Bring the rooks in the game, then do some c4, but first stop the knight on c6 of coming to d4, and then in some time we should play f4.
Okay.
And f7 will be weak.
So you want to play f4 at some
yes.
point. All right. So after a5, what did you play?
Queen d3.
Queen to d3. Mm-hmm.
Bishop into d5. Knight into d5. Bishop f8. King h2.
Okay.
Threatening bishop h3. So rook f, rook c, rook d8.
I think bishop into d5 from him was not the best move.
Yes.
Yeah?
But he was planning for bd5, ed5. Bishop f8, bishop d5, nd5 is also coming, no?
Ah, sorry.
Yes.
This is hanging here.
Yes, so bishop d5, nd5 is better.
Yeah, this is what you played in the game.
Yes,
yeah,
bishop f8, king h2, and he was main planning for knight e7, and the other knight will also go. But here bishop h3 is there, no?
So he missed this move.
No, he was planning for knight e7. But I played this, so you have to play rook d8.
Okay, you didn't give him a chance.
No.
Then?
Rook d8, bishop h3.
Okay.
Queen b7.
Mm-hmm.
Now rook ad1.
Okay, but now he can play
this. Yes, knight e7. Rook d2.
So you are not afraid that he would exchange the knights?
No, because after ed5, the knight d5, ed5, and the d6 pawn completely blocks the bishop on f8 and rook on d8.
Okay, so these two guys here are passive. But did you consider taking with the
yes,
queen?
Yes, but I don't want to go in the endgame because it's opposite color. And the only weakness d6 is supported by the dark square bishop.
Okay.
And I didn't have a dark square bishop.
So you think that although white might be slightly better, it's
but
not enough
yes,
to win?
Yes.
But here, you are not afraid that it's still opposite colored bishops?
No, because queens are on the game, so I can attack.
Okay.
And two rooks. So here queen c7.
So this is what happened in the game.
Yes.
He played queen c7.
F4.
And in opposite colored bishop middle games, what is the most important thing according to you?
Squares. The means I should not make weakness on the dark squares, and my opponent should not weakness on the light square because he is not having a light square bishop.
Okay.
So
but now how do you continue the attack? Because the king looks pretty safe here. I mean, I think all these pawns here. So
but now f4 I played, f4, and now the f file is opening. So now I will double the rooks, and when he plays f6, I will get the e6 square very
to put your bishop
yes,
here.
Yes, and
okay.
No one can attack the bishop.
So you played f4 and your opponent took.
Yes, rook okay. takes.
Rook takes on f4.
Bishop e7. This was a blunder. Rook f7.
Wow. And how quickly did you spot this?
2-3 minutes. I first only calculated if he plays bishop b7, rook f7 is simply winning.
Okay. So what should he have played here? Maybe g6?
No.
Or that
g6, rook f2.
Okay.
Then f5, g4. Or bishop into f5 is also coming at some time.
This might not be enough, but
yes,
here I think bg7 and
yes.
he can defend.
But now some
maybe g4 as you suggested.
Yes.
Is
but bishop h6, rook f3, fg4, fg4,
okay.
f4, g5 is coming. So it's lost. So fg4, bishop into g4, and the e6 square is too much weak.
And this king is looks weaker than this guy.
Yes. And some h5 is also coming.
Okay.
So he played, but the best was I think rook b7. It supports the f7 pawn.
Here.
Yes. Not here, but rook f7 is coming.
Yeah, here you can.
Here not back. g6 is wrong.
Rook
f2 and take the queen out of the diagonal. Some queen c5.
But this still looks very scary,
yes,
right?
Rook takes.
But
bishop
now you can't play this because this guy is hanging. So if you play
bishop
this,
queen
f2 is just losing. So maybe this was the right way for him to play. But in the game he played rook f4, bishop e7.
Rook f7.
And then you took.
Yes.
He has to take, right?
No. King into f7, this goes in the mate. Bishop e6.
Bishop e6, okay. So, what if I play king e8?
Queen into h7.
But where is the mate now? Queen
now.
g8
Queen g6.
Queen g6 is a threat. Let me try to move my rook maybe here.
This is losing, right?
So how? I'm sure this loses, but you have to find the way how it loses.
Queen g8 check.
Okay. Bishop f8.
No. Queen g8 check. Queen h5 check clearly wins.
Queen h5. Okay, that's a nice check. I have to go here.
Yes, queen h8.
And then queen h8. And I have to give the bishop. And what if I play g6 here? You will anyway take.
Yes.
And then I play this. You
queen
g8
lost.
Check. Okay, that's cool. So, in the game he didn't take your gift on
yes.
f7.
Rook f8.
But this is already much better for you.
Rook f8, rook into f8, bishop into f8. Rook into f8, b5 is hanging.
This pawn was hanging,
yes.
So he took with the bishop.
Bishop e6 check. King h8. Rook f2. Threatening rook f7.
Mm-hmm.
Bishop e7. And also threatening queen into b5. Because rook into b5, rook f8 is mate.
Correct. Okay. So this was a threat. So he moved his bishop.
Yes.
Now did you go in?
Rook f5. Threatening rook h5. And it's will be a force mate.
Mm-hmm.
h6 queen g6.
Okay. h6 queen g6 with rook h6,
yes,
as a threat.
And queen g8,
okay.
Also if bishop f8.
Okay.
So he played rook h6, he played rook f7, rook f8, rook into f8.
So here were you scared that it might be a drawish position?
No,
okay.
The b5 pawn is
you were winning another pawn. So this was easy,
yes.
Yeah, now, and you converted this into a win.
Yes.
So, Om, tell me, how did it feel to win the Asian Championship?
It was really, I was really feeling very proud.
You're feeling very proud, but
yes.
Last round, you lost the
yes.
game,
yes.
But you were still the champion. So, was it like, why did you lose the last round?
I completely miscalculated the last end game.
Okay. Or you were already very happy that you had won the tournament. So you had some excitement. Who is your favorite chess player?
Magnus Carlsen.
You like Magnus?
Yes.
Why?
He is really sharp and tactical.
Okay. And do you read chess books?
Yes.
Which is your favorite book?
Dvoretsky's Endgames.
Dvoretsky's Endgames?
Yes.
Have you studied them?
Yes.
Okay. So you know all the pawn endgames,
yes,
and everything. Right. Are you only 10 years old? Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay. You know so much. So it's a wonderful game. Thanks for sharing with us and good luck for rest of your tournaments.
Thanks.